Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to paint a metallic object, in this case here, this medieval helmet. I did a quick pre-sketch, as you can see here, and some acrylic underpainting, so that I could start to paint right now, after this acrylic paint was dry. Yes, and I ran into the problem that there is basically no real way of showing this in an interesting way than with a time-lapse. So I will show you this video here in a time lapse and will zoom in and comment on every really important aspect of this whole thing. The basics of painting metal is that you have to know beforehand if this is how reflective this object is that you paint. Metal itself is between a completely matte and black surface and a chromatic surface is anything in between possible. In this case, we have a helmet that is pretty glossy and pretty reflective, but not like a chromatic surface. You know, I put in already some details that you need, definitely need, when it comes into painting a metallic object, especially such a battered and dented helm. Basically, I put in some darker spots and below them, where the light hits, some lighter spots. And this pretty much gives immediately the impression of having some dents in this metal object here. And back to the topic, we have in this case a metallic object that is reflective but not like a mirror. It is not completely polished, but it is so much polished that you need to put in all those different colors that surround this helmet. And in this case, we have the sky. Therefore, this bluish color. We have those brownish spots here, where some people were standing around, or some trees, or whatever. And we also have a lot of nuances of the different reflections, like this one here, where other spots hit this whole thing, other light sources. This here is another important thing, light up this reflection here, and then I put in those small little scratches, and I do this by wiping off the brush, the color of the brush, and going over this whole thing just with a pure white with a very tiny bit of color on. And with this you get very much immediately the impression of some scratches on this battle-dented helm. These are again some very fine details that you need to put in to have this impression of metal, of a semi-glossy, shiny metal piece, like that we have here. And this takes a while, but it's pretty necessary to get this thing realistic looking. If you don't do this, it will look like a piece of plastic. Yeah, and so I basically put on the color according to my reference material. And you have to be pretty precise when it comes to all those reflections that you see on your reference material. All those color variations that you have. I mean, you will see that the palettes, I premixed a handful of colors, but I go on basically mixing more and more colors as I go, according to this reference that I have. And all those colors really make this thing come to life. Especially on this darker side here, you have a strong reflection from the right side, and this is something you need to put in so that it looks really realistic. My tip would be to really follow the reference as good as possible by premixing the colors as good as possible, and really take your time to see what's going on there. Basically, here we have a piece of the helmet that is convex. It's coming a bit out. And we have to paint this thing like we have reflections from below. And the same goes for this part here. We have the edge of the metal piece below this convex piece of metal, and there the sunlight hits very strong And this is something you need to put in. Some more little dents and scratches. Here I'm adding another scar, darker spot, and on the lower end where the sunlight reflects, I put in some more whitish reflections. And this is basically the part where this whole thing starts to look like metal. All those fine little reflections and dents and scratches. And I mean, you can't come up with this thing straight out of your mind. You have to follow the reference as best as possible to get this thing looking realistic onto the canvas. As you can see here also, I'm adding more of these reflections here, pretty carefully. If you would not add those fine little reflections, this thing would look like a piece of plastic. And I think painting metal is not an easy thing, and you need definitely for this a good reference material. I mean, I didn't follow the reference material like a slave. I left out some of these details, those knob-like things. I think they were not necessary to show you how to build up a metallic object like this here. I'm adding some more really pure, nearly pure white bits of color. I have even more reflections in. And this really helps to get this metallic effect onto the canvas. I'm toying around, you see, I put in some more of those reflections and then I go back and adjust them again. Some of them were too strong in my opinion. Some more details, and that's a finished helmet. So that's it for today, and let me know if you want to see more of these material tutorials here on my channel, down in the comment section below.